Hi, and welcome to this simple gift notelet tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to make this little gift set, which includes these cards. And we will be making this one in the video. There are also matching envelopes to add that little bit extra. We will be using the cling stamp Blissful and the transparent stamps, Blessings and Embellishments. For a full list of other products used, please refer to my blog. To begin, I've taken a white card blank, a piece of white cardstock, and a piece of mix and match fern green cardstock. I'm going to take the white cardstock and I'm going to ink up the Blissful stamp with Memento Pistachio ink. In this instance, we only need to ink up half the stamp to cover the paper. Press firmly down and then remove the card. Once this is dry, I've then gone round the edge with an alcohol marker. I'm using a Mauve La Plume pen for this one. This will actually add definition to the actual design when you place it on the white card. I also repeat this process on the coloured card. And then you can mount them onto the card blank. I'm actually going to take the Sentiment Blessings from the Blessings transparent stamp set. And I'm going to emboss the sentiment onto my patterned panel. I'm going to rub an anti-static bag over the top first so that I don't get any stray embossing powder where I don't want it. I'm going to use VersaFine black ink and stamp my sentiment towards the bottom of the card. I'm then going to use clear embossing powder and heat to set. Once I've done this, I'm then going to take the Cut Here stamp and just ink up the end to get the dotted line and stamp to create a line underneath my sentiment. Again, emboss it to finish off. So here you can see the finished card. And here are some other examples using other sentiments from other clear sets in the new Penny Black Take Flight range. I've also done an envelope with a matching flap for each of the coloured cards, as you can see here. This is how easy it is to do. Mask off the flap of the envelope with a piece of paper. Ink up your stamp, again with pistachio ink. And then stamp onto the flap. Again, pressing firmly. I'm now going to create a wrap for the notelets and I'm going to use the To You From Me sentiment. Rub an anti-static bag over a strip of vellum and then stamp the sentiment with VersaMark ink and cover with white embossing powder. Heat this to set it. Then rub the anti-static bag over again. Put VersaMark ink onto the cling stamp and stamp on either side of the vellum strip. Add white embossing powder, and heat again to set on each side. You can now place the wrap round your cards and envelopes and seal the back with a little piece of double-sided tape. I'm then going to take the packaging from one of my cling stamps. I'm going to cut off the tab bit from the end and use it as my packaging for this little notelet set. So I place my notelet set inside, and I'm then going to put double-sided tape along the little flap at the top. I'm going to create a flap using this Spellbinders Labels 20 die. First, cut the die out through your machine. Then place Spellbinders Tan embossing mat underneath and run through the machine again to get an embossed edge. I have to put several shims on mine as my machine's quite old. You can now see the slight pattern of the embossed edge. I then place it back in the die. Ink up my stamp again, this time I'm using Memento Pear Tart. And I'm going to stamp the image whilst the die is in place. This will allow me to have a white edge all the way around the actual piece. I'm then going to cut the piece in half lengthways and then place on either side of the tab with double-sided tape. And this will finalise the flap. I'm then going to take a piece of string and create a tiny bow. As you can see, I've got a little bow maker here, which makes making tiny bows really easy. I actually use crochet cotton, which is a good alternative if you can't get hold of any craft string. I'm then going to take a green button, thread the bow through the button with a bit of string, and adhere to the front of my flap. And as you can see, there's the finished flap. Thank you for watching. For a full list of materials, please visit my blog at candronicucardcraft.blogspot.co.uk.